Hey guys, it's Samuel here from How to FAQ, and today I want to show you how you can get started with APIs, and in particular how you can get started with some of Google's APIs. And I'm going to be showing you some things like the Google Maps API. So let's get started. So the easiest way to get to the Google Maps API is just to type Google Maps API, and it's the first result, Google Maps API, Google Developers. So you click on that and you can see the get started, and you can scroll down, you can see that Lyft actually uses this, you know, some companies use it. So you can see the real world implications of this. So click get started, and we want to use the directions API. And this is just going to tell us the exact directions between two given points that we can define either as actual longitude, latitude points, or just in kind of words, you know, names of towns, names of airports, etc. So you can see some sample code actually gives a JSON response, and that's in Python terms is a dictionary. So how are we going to get started? So first of all, I'm just going to open new window of Python, and I'm going to have this here, and we can start coding some stuff, and I'll get the idle up as well. And yeah, so first we're just going to click get key, and I'm just going to call this directions API. Yeah, that'll do. And it'll load, and you'll see it loading, and it will create the project, and then it should give us an API key. And what we can do with that API key is we can actually, so now we have, okay, we can actually access the Google Maps directions API, get directions between two places. Okay, so now we have the API key, and we have a rough idea what sort of output we're going to get sort of along this sort of time. So we're going to use this base URL in order to work stuff out. So if we open up Python, and I'm just going to start off by saying import url lib.request, because we're going to need that for sure, because we're doing an API request. And this is probably the easiest way of doing it. And I'm going to actually make an endpoint for our API, which an endpoint is essentially where you send the request to. So I'm just going to use their endpoint here. So they've basically used this base URL. You give the formatting in JSON. There we go. JSON. So that means we're going to get a response in JSON rather than, say, XML. Okay, so we have the base endpoint here, and I'm actually going to get the API key as well. Let's just get that back. If we click get key, click back on this project, and we can just quickly copy it across into our Python file, and then we can actually start. And we'll just copy it across into here. So that's our API key. Yeah, and we have our endpoint. And we're gonna now think about how the API requests are set up. So in the API requests, they basically have an origin and a destination. So in this example, I'm gonna actually ask the user for the origin, just to make it a nice little project. Where are you? And we're not going to use longitude, latitude, because I think it probably will work better if we just make it so it uses the basic search that we use in Google Maps. Say you're using it on your phone, for example. Where do you want to go? ? Okay, and now we can build up our navigation request. So navigation underscore request. And we could just simplify this down to nav request, I guess. And this is going to involve the origin. So we have to define the origin. And we need to define the destination. And you can see it kind of builds up in like a standard way that a URL would. And we If you're wondering how I'm working this out, if you just click done for a second, if you look down here, the example request is very helpful. We can see we need to add the key at the end, and we have origin and destination. So that's the kind of format I'm following. Any spaces we replace with a plus. Yeah. Okay. And if we want to put postcode, then that's we can put like a comma or something. Yeah. Okay. So we have the destination, and you can see from the request here, we're also going to need to add the API key. So I'm going to put a little ampersand sign, and key equals, and you can see I'm adding these curly brackets, and what that's going to do is it's going to allow me to use the string formatter in Python and input the strings I want in these places. It's kind of a nice way of doing it. So I'm going to put origin, comma, destination, comma, and then API key. There we go. So now we have our request built up, and we now need to start actually building the request so we can send it. So we've got the built request, we just need to send it. So also going to get JSON, because that will be useful when receiving the actual request into a dictionary. Okay, so I'm going to do request. Request equals now will equal the endpoint plus the nav request, and we're going to have to use I'm going to do response. Yeah, we're going to use the URL lib.request to do this. I'm going to set variable response to be the response of the API request we make. So request URL lib request actually. Request, and I'll leave this all on my GitHub page. If you have any questions, do put them down in the comments. Sure, we got .url open, and now we just put request. So that will send that request, opening the URL, and we're going to read it. And now we have the response as a string. So if we want to actually get the directions, we do directions equals json.loads the response, and I suppose we can print that, and you'll see that it'll be pretty extensive because they do give you a lot of information. Okay, so now I think we're pretty much done. The API key is ready. The last thing I'd say that we might be a good idea to do is on each of these, just maybe put replace the spaces with plus, because it's obviously a URL, it can't have any spaces. It has to have a plus in this sort of request. And now we're just going to run it, click F5, and you can see it says, where are you? And I'm just going to put London, Heathrow, and so I've said I want to navigate from London to Heathrow. It's going to make an estimate of where I mean, and it's going to guess Heathrow Airport most likely, and it's going to print the different types of ways I could go. And you can see there's quite a number of different ways that I could go in this case, and you can see all the directions are here. Now what we're going to do is we're going to just decipher this so we can find out how long it will take to walk. So you can see the main structure involves, first of all, several different routes. So we can set the routes. If you scroll down, you'll see there's a key called routes. So if we go, the nice way of navigating this will be go directions.keys. You can see that there's three main keys of this dictionary. Geocoded waypoints, routes, and status. Status is basically saying whether the route's fine to take or whether it's impossible, basically. So we're going to want to go for routes. So I'll set a variable routes equals directions routes, and we'll now do routes dot keys. Oops, accidentally forgot that part. The routes dot keys, because it's a list of all the different routes, we're going to want to just go to the first one and then see what we options we have. So now we're in the first one, you can see we have the option to go for legs. And legs refers to the walking distance in this state, and there's obviously a summary which would obviously tell you how roughly how far or what sort of directions you would need to take, etc., in terms of walking. Okay, so if we just go routes, and we're just going to go legs, and just like a little key in a dictionary. Now when we print this out, you'll see there's multiple different routes that you can go via walking. So we're actually gonna, I'm just gonna take this, set this equal to legs, and what we're gonna do is we're gonna, so I'm gonna call this legs, and we're just gonna test what the length of legs is to see if there's more than one route, which is probably likely there's only one route, but we'll see. Yeah, there's only one route. So we can go legs, 0, first index, and we wanna go find the distance, and we want it in text format. So it will give you either the value in meters or the actual text format, which is a rounded value. So let me give you this. So you can see right there, that is the distance in the take. So if you want to use this for some sort of API, then you're going to have to look through this code and understand how it's working and how it's been developed with these keys in this JSON format. And you'll work out where the parts you need to access are. So it's pretty straightforward, and there's a lot of good documentation on Google's website, and a lot of people on Stack Overflow as well have talked about this. So this is just a really easy implementation of the Google Maps API. These 11 lines of code here could be used to implement most of Google's APIs. For example, another API they do is the Street View API. It'll show pictures around the country, and you can download them. So that's pretty cool. And there's other Google Maps APIs as well. If you're feeling a bit ambitious and you want to try out some other APIs, just go API Google, and it will show you, where the APIs are, and you can see the API library is a good one to look at, and you can see all the different APIs they serve and how you can use them. And obviously, this is brilliant for all types of Android apps. Like I mentioned earlier, Lyft actually use this. So guys, I hope this has been a helpful learning experience for you. If you want to see any cool projects with this, or you have any queries or problems with this code, likewise, it will be on my GitHub page. And see you guys in the next video. Make sure you get subscribed, and so you don't miss future content. And I'll see you in the next video, guys. Goodbye.